About an hour and a half ago, 20-year-old Colin Fitch told me he was invited back to the Saratoga County Sheriff's Office last night around 8 o'clock and was asked if he wanted to press charges against an officer. The officer is the sergeant Fitch met unexpectedly around 1 in the morning Friday in the Walmart in Half Moon, the supercenter there. Fitch is the man on the left in this video that's all over the internet. It shows the officer cursing at Fitch and demanding his car keys so that Fitch's car can be searched. Fitch says he never consented to that search. The chief deputy told us yesterday an internal investigation is going on.
Does he take the keys from you, or did you actually hand them over to him in some fashion?
He actually, after I was struck, he actually basically just took them out of my hand without my permission or anything.
You want to resist? Search the car.
He just took them, went about it, and tossed them to the other officer, and he searched my car without my consent.
I imagine they'll argue that they did have your consent because you can hear you on the tape saying, mm-hmm, or it sounds as though you're saying, yeah. It sounds as though they wore you down.
We're just going to check.
All right.
And be on our merry way. All right. Understand?
I can't really argue. I did mum or something, but I think it was just, you know, after he struck me, and I was just kind of in shock of what just happened. I wasn't at all agreeing to the search of my car or handing over the keys by any means.
He obviously reaches up with his right arm, and then you hear a smacking sound. What was that?
He actually did strike me on the left side of my head.
You want to resist?
Right by my ear, actually.
His whole hand or his fingers or what?
I mean, I couldn't really tell you. I was basically in shock that it happened. I mean, I don't know if it was an open hand or a punch or anything. I know he did strike me, though. I mean, I couldn't tell you what kind of hit it was, but he definitely did.
Fitch told me he wanted to hide his face because he's afraid other police officers might recognize him later and cause trouble. A CBS 6 News managerial decision is the reason we're no longer showing the officer's face. That may change. Yesterday, someone related to the officer told our Lynn Falsetti the sergeant has post-traumatic stress disorder from serving in the military. The officers went to the store in the first place because someone called in a suspicious car. Fitch told me tonight he had his rifle in the back seat, partially visible, and he says the officers let them go after he showed them that the rifle was legal.